Well, I got the Passat all loaded up here. I got my coffee in a mug. I got two engines and wiring harnesses in there. Can't get this open here. It's all locked up. Yeah, check this out. So we got four engines here and a couple wiring harnesses there. And we got this all loaded up.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah, we got a lot of stuff in there. It's squatting pretty good. And after I load this up, I was like, you know what? I'm going to have to cut out part of this frame here because it could rub on the frame. Like, I can't go over a bump without it. It should be good as long as I don't go over a bump. But today we're at 3,000. So we're here at the Tape Boss World Headquarters. And you may recognize this. This is the Cummins diesel in this Tahoe. And there's a whole sequence of videos here. And here's the man himself, the inventor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How's it going? Welcome. To give you a tour through the shops too.
Yeah, we got an imprint of a hammer here. Did you do that on by mistake?
Yeah, saw right beside it. And there's wrenches in the other. There's a handsaw. Even though I've never used a handsaw in my life.
Oh, you meant to do that?
Yeah. And then there's a bunch of wrenches in the other pad there. So
what are you breaking today?
MX-255. It's got a couple leaks in the back. It's got all these steel lines for the auxiliaries, but I think it was a plow truck because some of these are pretty rotten. So there's 10 different lines, and they're all between $400 and $600.
Yeah.
And they're all kind of iffy. So I replaced the ones that really needed to be replaced, and then like the really funky angles that are tight. But I got a couple cheaper hoses made that do the exact same thing.
Yeah.
Like this hose is $100 compared to the $600 that Case wants.
Oh, boy.
And it's, like, you replace all those lines, it's like $5,000.
Oh,
so
wow.
So trying to save a little bit and still make it do exactly what it wants.
Yeah.
So there's, I just bought the air fitting. That's off a transport truck for the air seat. Case wants $255 for a little 90 degree 5/32 airline 90 degree fitting,
like somewhere around here.
Piss me off! It shouldn't be legal. And then this one had a steering motor leak. I'll make a video on that. The steering cylinder was dripping all over the floor, and then the wheel seal was leaking. And then it's ready for the fields again.
Yeah.
So this one's kind of the odd man out.
And this is the truck, another sequence of videos on this build. This was a complete rebuild and take this from that and a few trucks donated to make this one-of-a-kind special.
This basically took three trucks to put together. We made it from two-wheel drive to four-wheel drive.
Yeah,
Took out the gasser and put in the Cummins and took out the automatic and put the MV4500 in it.
And it was a 94 truck with a 87, was it 9 or 89?
This is an 85.
85.
Dodge stopped making a crew cab in 85, but they didn't start putting the Cummins in until 89.
Oh, that's what it was.
We took the best of every generation and put it in this one.
So. Yeah.
I just got to wire up the taillights yet, and then it's going for the drive shaft. So.
And this is the work in progress that you were, you're having some kids come down.
Yeah, we work on this one every other Friday night with a bunch of kids. This one's got the engine completely rebuilt. The transmission's been done, all new brakes, all new lines, and that's how we got it. And then I'm doing most of the work. We don't get a whole lot done with the kids, but they're really enjoying it. So, and then I think we might be auctioning this one off or raffling this one off when it's done. So
yeah,
the interior's getting done right now, and you can see most of the parts that are already done. They're hanging on the wall there.
Oh yeah.
So. Those are all.
Now, did you guys decide on a name for it? I know everybody was commenting on what it
was. That was this one. That's
Well, this one was a discrepancy in the year.
Oh, yeah. So we thought it was a 47 Style Master, but it's actually a 48 Fleet Master.
So yeah, yeah.
The Fleet Master had more chrome and was a higher options car.
Yeah. Yeah. And this is the Dakota in the, like, it, we had, you guys came up with a name for it.
Yeah, so it's R.T. Baker. So
R.T. Baker, that's what you guys decided?
Yeah, so that's what the owner decided on in the end. So this I'm really enjoying this project. This is a 52 Studebaker on a 02 Dakota R.T. with a 360 Magnum.
Yeah.
So I should grab the battery and fire it up for you, but
and I loved how you got the gauges to work and everything, that the servos and
Just put the step motors on the back.
I love that.
Yeah. That's a working tack from the spare speedometer from the Fleet Master. Yeah.
Yeah.
So all the wiring in that's under the dash here.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah. And then that'll all be covered up by some tin work that I did. So this was brand new steel. So we put a...
Yeah, purposely rusted it and match it.
Hydrogen peroxide and vinegar, and then we stamped out the RT and the Baker.
Yeah, well, I saw that. I was like, oh, man, that's a nice addition.
Yeah, so it'll have the name kind of... I don't know if you can see that in the light.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so just subtly.
Yep.
But that'll cover up everything now, under there. And matches pretty decent.
Now, when you were cutting the metal, you used the tape boss to take the measurements? There's your plug.
You know what? It's really great for doing stuff like this. Like I had to build the box out for the drum brakes.
Yeah, I remember.
So I had to fold that all out. So it's nice to know like your height, your distances, and I only went to the brake once, popped it in, and it fit really good. So you don't have to write anything down on that. It does work really handy for that.
Even the wiring, you could use it just to remember, like, okay, you know, pin number one is pink, and pin number seven is black.
Exactly. And even the floor on that thing, I need a piece of steel that's like 26 by 21 and 9/16, and then folded down in the one corner. So it just saves a lot of trips back and forth.
Yeah.
So...
Oh, right on.
Yeah, so the box for this is outside, matches the same patina, and then the doors. I gotta build a steering wheel cover for it yet, so working on that too.
Just
covering that up so that it's nice and clean. And then, as a joke, I think when he comes to pick up the truck, I'm gonna have to make a little first aid box with a tetanus shot in there. If he's ever in an accident, I don't want to hear about it. So they're making the rad for it right now.
Yeah. Oh, man, lots of progress, eh?
That's
for the truck.
Four-wheel drive truck, yeah. Only a few little things left. A patch in the firewall, fifth wheel hitch.
And that's a lot of work.
No shortage of things to do. But,
that's for sure. Yep.